says that sometimes he misses the time so much that he might tear out a bit by himself.
Hello. 안녕하세요. 저는 앙목교 체라벨라에서 한국 음식을 팔고 있는 서진원이라고 합니다.
Hello, 안녕하세요. I'm Chela, his daughter, and I'm also the co-owner of Chelabella Korean Food. We specialize in our kimchi, our side dishes, our radish kimchi, our non-spicy radish kimchi, and our army stew. The name Chelabella actually is my nickname, so my friends used to call me Chelabella, and I found it very catchy, like the famous brand Coca-Cola, and I wanted it to be as famous and as, you know, inspiring as them, so I named it Chelabella.
일단 제 음식은 모든 음식이 다 제가 직접 만든 소스로 만들고 있고, 특히 김치 같은 경우에는 그 싱가포르에 있는지 없는지 모르겠지만 그 저기 막 고기를 안 먹는 사람들도 먹을 수 있는 그런 김치입니다. 그래서 김치 안에 뭐 액젓이나 그런 게 들어가지 않는 베지테리안도 먹을 수 있는 김치라고 저는 자부합니다.
He says the special thing about our dishes are that everything is made by him, including the sauce, you know, the marinating and everything. And especially about the kimchi is that he made it without fish sauce, so everyone can eat, including vegetarians.
Last time I working the Marsiling Road 136. Then now the change lady then block 603 Angmokgyo Avenue 5. Marsiling around the 2016 or 17 open the last year cross lady. Because the manpower problem, so very difficult. So many time thing, 1 month, 2 month, 3 month. Then after that, change better than one person do. So now the only the 4 or 5 food, but last time the I working the mastering there around the 22 food. So now the very less.
So actually I was born in Korea and I came over to Singapore when I was primary 2. My dad wasn't with me yet then. He was still in Korea working a corporate job. Then afterwards, we decided that Singapore is a really nice place to be in, so our family wanted to migrate here. And then from there, he came here, then he was wondering what he can offer to Singapore because his English wasn't that good. Then he thought, food, you don't need to speak to make good food. So he thought that he wanted to open a restaurant. Then that's how he started to start selling Korean food in Singapore. His first store was in Tiong Bahru. Then afterwards, he moved to UT. Then we moved to Marsiling, then Ang Mo Kio. So he had a lot of experiences even before this.
먼저 레스토랑을 한 3개월 정도 해봤는데 음식값이 너무 비싸고 그래서 여기 대중들한테 선보일 수 있는 많은 사람한테 좀 더 이렇게 맛보게 할 수 있는 거를 하다 보니까는 이제 푸드코트를 시작을 했고 지금은 이제 커피숍을 한 이유는 푸드코트는 내 마음대로 쉴 수가 없는데 커피숍은 그래도 좀 너무 힘들 때는 좀 쉴 수가 있어서 이제 커피숍으로 옮긴 거죠.
He says that he wanted to try opening a restaurant initially, but actually the startup cost was very high compared to opening in a food court or coffee shop. And he felt that if he opens a restaurant, he only reach the Koreans in Singapore, but his goal was to reach the Singaporeans in Singapore. Then he started off at a food court, but he moved to a coffee shop because at a food court, you cannot close anytime you want, but over here, you can close when you're very tired, you can just, you know, take a break.
생각을 해보면 싱가포르에서 한 14년, 15년 살면서 가장 힘든 건 언어 문제도 있겠지만 그 중에서 가장 힘들게 저는 생각하는 게 가족 간에 시간이 없는 것. 제가 한국에 있을 때는 주말이나 홀리데이 같은 경우에는 무조건 어디 놀러 가고 밖에 나가고 외식하고 애들이 직업 짤 정도로 나갔는데 이 싱가포르에서는 이 직업이 직업이다 보니까 주말에 더 일하게 되고 그리고 퍼블릭 홀리데이 더 일하게 되다 보니까 아예 시간이 없어요. 그게 난 참 뭐라 그럴까 제일 큰 아쉽고 서운한 거 정말 어떨 땐 눈물도 나요.
He said thinking back to the 14, 15 years he had in Singapore, apart from the language barrier which everyone can expect to be a problem, he says that the biggest worries and the problem he has being in Singapore is that back in Korea when he worked a corporate job, he was free on the weekends, you know, on public holidays, he had time for family. He's a very family man and he always brought us around, you know, because we can go on like road trips and we had a lot of fun as a family. But after he started to work in this line of job especially, he had no time to spend with his children, his wife, so he actually felt that that is the biggest worry and the problem he has living in Singapore more so than others. He says that sometimes he misses the time so much that he might tear out a bit by himself. Yeah.
그전이나 지금이나 앞으로도 내 음식을 이렇게 맛있게 먹어주는 손님들이 있는 이상은 저는 항상 행복할 것 같습니다. 진심.
From the bottom of his heart, he feels that as long as there's people that enjoy his food, he'll be the happiest man in Singapore. And as for me, I came a very long way working with my dad. Originally, it was quite tough for me to get used to the cultural environment because I always work in like aircon cafes, like, you know, in places that are different from coffee shops. But I'm really, really thankful for everyone who said kind words to me. Like, they told me to 加油, fighting, you know, everything. So I'm really thankful that everyone was so nice to me, and I will try my best to give back to them. And I hope that everyone will give us a visit because it's authentic Korean food made by a Korean chef and also a Korean cashier. So yes, thank you.